Hello, everybody. This is DFS Chan coming to you here to talk about July 29th, League of Legends DFS Slate. Welcome for those of you who are new. I saw that some people have messaged me on Twitter. So welcome to you guys if you are watching this for the first time. But we try to go over, you know, each DFS slate for League of Legends. And I also share some match predictions here and favorite plays here. And then, you know, my exact match predictions and some favorite picks, prop bets on my Patreon. You can go check that out on my Twitter account at DFS underscore Chan. Without any further ado, let's dive in. So we have a 4-game slate, 2 games in China and 2 games in Korea, as always, on Thursday nights. I just wanted to point out generally, as like a general observation, that we are approaching, you know, pretty close to the playoff time. So, you know, at the end of the summer split, for those of you who may not know, there will be a playoff tournament for the top, you know, six teams, seven teams, eight teams, depending on which region you're talking about. But, you know, these weeks, starting this week and next week, are, you know, going to be the last, you know, 2-3 weeks that are going to be very critical for those teams that are either in the mix or in the top, you know, 3 or 4 seeds, just to kind of, you know, for seeding purposes, just like in any other sports. So I will talk a little bit more about, you know, if there is any playoff motivation for some of these teams, because that really matters a lot. Or rather, it's a key factor in our analysis when this time comes. I think sometimes that is what puts them over the edge, if it's a close matchup. And also if it's like a, you know, big heavy favorite matchup, that, you know, sometimes those elite teams lack motivation playing against like really bad teams. But then if they have a playoff motivation, that sometimes they, you know, tend to stay more focused and, you know, win those games in more, you know, in a more dominant fashion. So anyway, that's something that I just wanted to point out. Starting today, probably I'll kind of talk about that a little more in my videos. So yeah, in the LPL, as mentioned, these are the two teams, two games, Top Esports versus Thunder Talk, and then Weibo Gaming versus LGD. Top Esports is a big favorite at -1,000 over Thunder Talk, and then Weibo Gaming is a big favorite over LGD as well. So I have my notes here, but as you can see here on my notepad, I think Top Esports obviously should win. I mean, I think they're going to win the series, but there is a good chance that Thunder Talk can take a game in the series. I mean, Thunder Talk has been playing really well, especially the jungler in Baechuan and the bottom lane, Kepler and Yao Yao. After they were injected into this lineup, Baechuan and Kepler and Yao Yao have been playing really well. And Yukal actually had a really good series, last series out. That was probably the best games, a string of two or three games. I forgot how many games he played in that series, 2 or 3. But man, he was really, really good. And I know he scored really well for DFS purposes. Hoya is a bit of a liability, but he's going up against the weakest player on top esports and Wayward. So I'm not too concerned about that. But like I said, Top Esports should win the series. But I think Thunder Talk makes a very, very interesting GPP play today, just based on the recent form that they've been in. And Top Esports, they've already clinched the playoffs. I think they're just playing for better seeding for playoffs purposes. So I think they may take a step back a little bit, or take their foot off the brake, foot off the gas a little bit. So I think there's a good chance that Thunder Talk could upset today, despite the odds. But yeah, I mean, I think 8 out of 10 times, I think Top Esports should win. But Thunder Talk, they've been in good form. I mean, I'll talk about LGD here in a second, but Thunder Talk has been in really good form. As you can see here, I mean, they're like in the middle of the pack team now. I mean, they're 5-6 in the series. They are still like in the playoff hunt over Fun Plus Phoenix more critically. So I do think Thundertalk has a shot, but not a good shot, but a shot. Whereas in the other matchup in China, LGD, I don't think they have any shot against Weibo Gaming. And I'll talk about that right now. Weibo Gaming has been playing really well, especially the top half of the lineup with the Shy, SOVFM, and Angel. SOVFM has had really, really good games, but then really, really bad games. But going up against a really bad team in LGD, who is starting again, Kui, Hai Chao, whom I really don't like over their, teammates that are in the same position, like Kui versus Shadow in that jungle position. I very much prefer Shadow. And then Hai Chao versus Yeji. I very much prefer Yeji over Hai Chao. So, you know, I just don't feel like LGD has what it takes to win here today against Weibo Gaming. And then I mentioned about the playoff implications. I think, Weibo Gaming does have playoff implications here. They can claim the fifth spot over EDG with a win tonight here. As you can see, Weibo Gaming is sitting at 8-4 in series. And Edward Gaming, EDG, is sitting at eight wins and eight and five, basically. So if Weibo Gaming wins, they'll be 9-4, and they will have one game up on EDG on the standings. And it's critical because, I mean, 9-4, they really need these wins, especially against bad teams like LGD. I know LGD is coming off of a win, but it was against Team WE, the bottom of the bottom teams, bottom tier teams. So it wasn't that impressive of a win. Frankly, I think WE should have won that game in that series, in my opinion, but it is what it is. But yeah, so I do think Weibo Gaming should win probably 9.5 out of 10 times today. I'm very, very confident that Weibo Gaming will win the series. Now, the question is, can LGD take a game off Weibo Gaming in the series? I mean, they could. I can maybe see a path. Let's see. Behind Kui and the bottom lane. Kui had one good game in that series against Team WE, but then Team WE had Vu as the jungler who started, who's not very good. So, and Kui, in my opinion, is not a very good jungler. So I just think it has to come from the bottom lane with Awesome and Jin Zhao. And I just feel like based on their recent bad form, they've been in really, really funky form, Awesome and Jin Zhao, and it's not a good one. So as much as Huanfeng and On have struggled this split, I just feel like they're still a tier above on Awesome and Jin Zhao. So I fully expect Weibo Gaming win here tonight, and I don't think I'm going to have any exposure to LGD. So for those of you who are playing the deep GPP, yeah, I mean, LGD, I think would probably give you the most leverage, in my opinion, tonight with good kill upside potential in that matchup. As you can see, the kill upside for both of these Chinese matchups are really good. TES versus TT, the combined kills per minute is at 0.78. And over under, set by Vegas is at 26 kills total for that matchup. So that's really good. And comparatively, the Weibo Gaming versus LGD is sitting at 25 over under kills. And then combined kills per minute of 0.78. So it's about the same, but you know, you can mix and match. But I just feel like LGD doesn't really have many paths to, you know, upset Weibo Gaming tonight. So I very much prefer Thundertalk as an underdog pick tonight with kill upside. And then in Korea, it's two games in Korea, Frederick Breon versus Kwangdong Freaks, and then Damwon Kia versus KT. This is an interesting matchup, I think. Both teams have struggled so much this split. Frederick Breon has, as well as Kwangdong Freaks. Frederick Breon has one win in the game, in the summer split. they have like been mixing players here and there. I know they had called up the new jungler and the new AD carry, I believe, but they have sent them back down to their minor league affiliate. Now they're starting either Morgan or Sword in the top lane, and then Umti, Lava, Henna, Delight. And that's not a very strong lineup. And going up against Guangdong Freaks, who has Keen in the top lane, Teddy in the AD carry position, and Fate has been up and down, but then LM has been really, really bad. But overall, Guangdong Freaks, you know, has better players, and they've been playing a little bit better, even though, like I said, both teams, you know, their form has gone down quite a bit this split. So I do think Fred and Breon has some chances to upset Guangdong Freaks, but I think Guangdong Freaks should end up winning the series in probably 7 out of 10 times, in my opinion. But nonetheless, I'm not very much interested in either team tonight, Fred and Breon or Guangdong Freaks, because the over-under and combined kills per minute, which measures the kill upside for this matchup, is sitting at 0.60. And like I said, over-under sitting at 21. So that's, you know, significantly lower than the Chinese matchups that we just talked about. So, and like I said, this is really one of the lowest combined kills per minute and over under numbers that we have seen this split. So I really don't see much of a kill upside for either team. I just feel like it's going to end maybe like 12-8 or like 13-7 or something like that. So I just feel like that is not going to be good enough to take down a GPP or, you know, or just win place in cash even, you know, for DFS purposes. And then the last game of the slate is Damwon Kia versus KT Rolster. Damwon Kia is a, you know, sizable favorite at -350. I do think their ownership is going to be really high, which very much interests me to play KT Rolster tonight. Not only because of that, but KT has been playing really, really well lately, you know, since the last time they played against each other head-to-head. KT, I'll go over KT first, because I do think KT can pull this off maybe like 2 or 3 out of 10 times. KT has been, you know, dominating in the bottom lane with Aiming playing really, really well, and then Rascal playing well in the top lane. Cuz has been okay, and then Vikla has been okay, but Vikla has also shown me that he can pop off as well if he hits, you know, all cylinders and gets it going early in the game. And against Damwon Kia, who's been playing really well here and there. I mean, I think Nuguri, Canyon, and Showmaker, the top three, top jungler and the mid laner for Damwon Kia, have been playing really well. It's been the bottom lane, Dukdam and Kellen, that have been a liability for that team. And going up against Aiming and Life, I don't know, man. Like, Aiming and Life have been really good. So I do think KT definitely has a shot. Their strength against DK's weakness in the bottom lane. And then, like I said, Vikla has been up and down. So if he, you know, is in good form, and I think he is, I mean, in the last series, he played really well, at least in one of the games. I do think he can beat Showmaker, but, you know, in 9 out of 10 times, I think Showmaker is a better player. And then Canyon is really good. So I think I give advantage to Canyon over Cuz. Nuguri has been playing well, but Rascal has been playing really well. I know he's been playing a lot of tanky champions in like Sejuani for Rascal, and that's been working out really well for KT, because they are putting a lot of the eggs in Aiming's basket, basically, and then let Aiming carry that team. And that could happen against Damwon Kia. And Damwon Kia struggles against early aggression, or has been struggling against early aggression teams in the summer split. And KT can be that team, really. I mean, KT, you know, with Aiming in Life and Cuz and Vikla, I do think early, maybe the first dragon fight that KT loves to engage in, I think that can kind of snowball KT's chances to upset Damwon Kia. So my ultimate match prediction for this matchup is Damwon Kia wins the series 2-1. But like I said, KT is a live dog, in my opinion, for DFS purposes. So if you are interested, Feel free to play KT. And the last time they played against each other here head to head, the kill upside was ended up being really good. And so I you see here over under set at 21, just like the Fred Brian versus Guangdong Freaks, but the combined kills per minute is actually a little bit higher than that Fred Brian Guangdong Freaks matchup. So I would definitely take a piece of this matchup, Damwon Kia or KT Rolster, and play them with my Chinese favorites or maybe Thunder Talk. So who knows? But like I said, I'm not going to be targeting the Fred Brian Guangdong Freaks matchup because that has the least kill upside. And then the third kill upside matchup is Damwon Kia versus KT. And then I think both Chinese matchups are about neck to neck in terms of kill upside. So I would just kind of treat them as the same, depending on who you think has a better shot at winning, securing a win in the series. And I do think that's Weibo Gaming. Even though Top Esports is a better team than Weibo Gaming, I think their Top Esports is going up against a tougher opponent in Thunder Talk. I just feel like LGD has no shot at beating WBG today with the playoff implications and just with all the matchup advantages that Weibo Gaming has. So yeah, that's all I got for you guys today. If you guys have any other questions, please let me know, holla at me. Otherwise, if you enjoy this video, that's been sponsored by TrueDFS. So go check out the channel at TrueDFS on Twitter. On YouTube, this is uploaded on TrueDFS YouTube account. So yeah, please go check it out. And otherwise, yeah, if you like this video, please hit the like button here below. And yeah, feel free to reach out to me if you have any questions. Have a good one. Good luck out there. Bye bye.